Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and today I'm going to show you how you can make 3 custom transitions in Final Cut Pro without having to download any plugins. Now, let's see if we can do this in 3 minutes or less. So, let's get 3 minutes up on the clock and get started. Place your playhead between your clips and go back 4 frames by using the left arrow key. Press Command B to blade it. Move your playhead 4 frames into the second clip and press Command B to blade it there. Next, select both clips, open the effects browser, navigate to the blurs category, and select zoom. Double click on this effect to apply it to both your clips. Place your playhead at the start of your first clip and select it. In the inspector, drag the zoom amount slider to 0 and add a keyframe. Next, scroll down and add a keyframe to the scale slider in the transform parameter. Move your playhead to the end of the clip, bring the zoom amount slider all the way up to 32, and set the scale slider to 1000%. Next, without moving your playhead, select the second clip, and add a keyframe to the zoom amount slider. Scroll down, set the transform scale to 1000%, and add a keyframe. Now, move your playhead to the end of the second clip, bring the zoom amount slider back down to 0, and set scale to 100%. Let's see how that looks. With your playhead between the two clips, use the left arrow key to go back 5 frames. Click and drag back your second clip until it snaps to the playhead. Blade both your clips where they overlap and place the playhead at the start. Next, select the top clip, bring the scale slider all the way down, and add a keyframe. Select your bottom clip and add a keyframe to the scale slider to lock it in at 100%. Move the playhead to the end of your transition and set the scale slider at 100% to your top clip and 1000% to the bottom clip. And last, from the effects browser, add a shape mask to your top clip. Adjust the feather ring until the hard edges just disappear. Let's have a look and see what that looks like. Select and blade the last 3 frames of your first clip and the first 3 frames of your second clip. Next, select both clips and apply the radial blur effect from the effects browser. Set your playhead at the start of the first clip and select it. Bring the blur amount slider down to 0 and click the keyframe button to add a keyframe there. Next, add a keyframe to the rotation and the scale sliders in the transform parameter. Move your playhead to the end of the first clip, bring the blur amount slider to around 25, and set rotation to 180 degrees. And scale to 400%. Now, without moving your playhead, select the second clip and add a keyframe to the blur amount slider. Next, set the rotation of the second clip to negative 180 degrees and scale to 400%, and add a keyframe to both. Move the playhead to the end of your second clip, set the blur amount back down to 0, rotation to 0, and scale back to 100%. Now, let's play that back and see how that looks. So there you go, 3 custom transitions you can try using in one of your next projects. If you like this video and would like to see more videos like this one, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. If you're new here, make sure to check out the rest of my channel, lots of Final Cut Pro tutorials there. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button below, new videos uploaded at least weekly. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.